Yesterday we have discussed about the stoichiometric point defect, and today we are discussing about the non-stoichiometric point defect. In the non-stoichiometric compound, what we find that the ratio of the cations to the anions is not same as in their ideal chemical formula. And for example, transition metal oxide, iron oxide, or say copper oxide, such compounds are known as non-stoichiometric compound, in which the ratio of the cation is not, the cation and anion is not similar or identical to the their chemical formula. So non-stoichiometric defect, the defects disturb the ratio of, this defect disturbs the ratio of number of positive and negative ion from that of the required by an ideal chemical formula of the compound. Types of non-stoichiometric point defect. Non-stoichiometric point defects are basically of two main types. Number one, metal excess defect, and number two, metal deficiency defect. What is metal excess defect? Metal excess defect may be because of the anionic vacancy. That means from the lattice side, some anions will be missing. In that case, obviously, the metal ions will be in excess. Or metal excess can also be caused due to presence of some extra cation or positive ion in the interstitial site. So let us understood the metal excess defect due to anionic vacancy or due to presence of extra cation in the interstitial site one by one. First of all, metal excess defect due to anionic vacancy. This defect is shown by alkali halides like NaCl, KCl, LiCl, CsCl, and so on and so forth. A compound may have metal excess defect, may have excess of metal ion if a negative ion is absent from its lattice site, leaving a hole which is occupied by electron to maintain electrical neutrality. That means metal excess is created when an anion moves from its normal lattice sites. A negative ion is absent from its lattice site, leaving a hole which is occupied by the electron to maintain the electrical neutrality. This is called metal excess defect due to anionic vacancy. This type of defect are found in the crystal which are likely to possess Schottky defect like NaCl, KCl, etc. Anionic vacancy in alkali halides are produced by heating alkali halide in an atmosphere of alkali metal vapor. That means when NaCl crystal is heated in presence of vapor of sodium metal, in that case the metal excess defect due to anionic vacancy will be produced. Under these conditions, alkali metal atom deposit on the surface of the alkali halide. When alkali halide are heated in the atmosphere of alkali metal, what will happen? Alkali metal vapor will condense on its outer surface. Under these conditions, alkali metal atoms deposit on the surface of the alkali halide crystal. When this happens, the halide ion move to the surface and combined with the metal ion. See here, what you see? From here, one halide ion, X minus, goes to the surface, and the moment it reaches to the surface, the M atom, metal atom, which is condensed, which is on the outer surface in the condensed form from the metal vapor, immediately give up one electron, metal atom M, give up one electron to form M plus metal ion, and which combines with the anion, which leave this normal lattice site. It is clear from the figure here. See here, from there, here, what happened? X minus ion move onto surface. There it combines with the metal atom. How it can combine? Anion can combine with the cation only. So what happens? The moment this anion approaches closer to the M atom immediately give up one electron, and that electron diffuses through the crystal and occupying the hole created by the anion when the anion move from this side to the lattice side. So what happened? Under these conditions, alkali metal atom deposit on the surface of the alkali metal halide, combines with the anion which come out of the crystal by leaving one electron, and that electron rush through the crystal and occupy the anionic side. The electron released during the conversion of metal atom into anion diffuses into the crystal and occupy the site vacated by the anion. The holes occupied by the electrons are called F center. This is called F center. Mark here, this is called F center. F center is the hole created by this hole. It is called F center. F center. F center. This center is known as F center. Electron entrapped in the anionic vacancy of metal excess crystal is called F center or colored center, and are responsible for the color of the compound and many other interesting properties. What are the interesting properties? Due to presence of this unpaired electron, the compound will show some paramagnetic behavior. Also, it will show some electrical conductance. Electrons, charge carried by the electrons, it will carry negative charge. So, N type of semiconductance will be exhibited. So, due to the presence of anionic vacancy, which is occupied by the electron, a colored center is formed called F center, and because of that, the alkali halides impart characteristic color on heating because of the formation of this colored center. And as this site of anion is occupied by electron, due to presence of this unpaired tone, the crystal will show some paramagnetic character also, and it will show N type of semiconductance. It will act as a semiconductor carrying negative charge. So this is what is metal excess defect due to anionic vacancy. When alkali metal halides are heated in the presence of vapor of alkali metal, the anion leave from the lattice site and thus onto the surface, where it combines by the cation formed by the release of electron by the metal atom. So M first get converted into M plus, leaving one electron. That electron rush through the crystal and occupy the lattice site from where the anion has left. This site inside the crystal where electron get entrapped is called F center, and it is because of the presence of this F center, color center is created. And this is the reason why alkali metal halide on heating impart characteristic flame. Number two, due to presence of this unpaired tone, the crystal starts showing paramagnetic character. Number three, because of the presence of this electron, it will behave like N types of semiconductor. Second metal excess defect is due to presence of extra cation into the interstitial site. Very common example, which is well explained in the NCERT book, is the zinc oxide. Zinc oxide, as its d orbital is completely full, so zinc oxide is a white compound. At room temperature, but on heating it turns yellow. Why it happens? Let us examine it. On heating, zinc oxide loses oxygen and turns yellow, as shown by this chemical equation. ZnO on heating forms zinc ion. Oxygen is released, which get disappeared in the atmosphere, leaving behind these two electrons. So what will happen when zinc oxide is heated? Some extra zinc ion will go into this interstitial site. On rest all other side, zinc ion and oxide ions are present, and one extra zinc ion is present in this interstitial site. So because of that presence of extra zinc ion, what will happen? Two positive charge will increase. To maintain the electrical neutrality, two electrons will occupy other interstitial site. So this is how it happened. And because of this, it becomes yellow. Not only that, because of this two unpaired electron, it will show paramagnetic character as well. It will show N type of semiconductance as well. So metal excess defect due to presence of interstitial cations. The very familiar example is zinc oxide, which is well explained in the NCERT book, and figure will be like this. Although figure is not given in the NCERT book, so please pay attention to this figure. Now the last defect is metal deficiency defect. What is metal deficiency defect? The non-stoichiometric compound may have metal deficiency defect. Metal deficiency defect. The non-stoichiometric compound may have metal deficiency defect due to the absence of metal cation. That means in such crystal, number of cation with respect to an ion is less. And this type of defect is shown by the metals who show variable oxidation state. That means transition metals like FeO, like nickel oxide, like copper oxide. You know that well, that iron has two oxidation state, plus 2 plus 3, copper 2 plus 2 3, and so on and so forth. So the metal deficiency defect is shown by the oxides of transitional metals like iron oxide, nickel oxide, cuprous oxide, etc. The non-stoichiometric compound may have metal deficiency due to the absence of metal cation from its electric site. And the charge is balanced by an adjacent cation having higher positive charges. Let us see the case of iron oxide. What happened? This is the crystal of iron oxide everywhere. And assume that one Fe2 plus ion is missing from this site. So what will happen? Due to missing of one Fe2 plus ion, there will be two extra negative charge. That means electrical neutrality will get disturbed. And to maintain that electrical neutrality, what will happen? The two adjacent Fe plus 2 ion will change itself into plus 3 ions. So, in crystal of FeO, some Fe2 plus ions are missing and the loss of positive charge is balanced by the required number of Fe3 ions lying adjacent to the that. Here and here, what do you see? At all the cationic side, cations are present. At all the anionic side, anions are present. But what we see in iron oxide, some of the lattice sites which are supposed to be occupied by the cation, their cation is missing. That means electrical neutrality is not maintained here. So in order to maintain the electrical neutrality, what will happen? Some adjacent metal cation will occupy some higher oxidation state so as to maintain the electrical neutrality. This is called metal excess defect, and numerical problems based on the calculation of number of Fe2 plus Fe3 plus ion or their percentage are asked that if the iron oxide has the composition 0.93 into O, that means for 100 oxygen atom there is only 93 iron atom, then find out the what is the ratio of the number of Fe2 plus and Fe3 plus ion or percentage of Fe2 plus or Fe3 plus ion. And the composition of iron oxide may vary in the range of 0.930 to 0.960. So there may be lots of questions based on this composition to find out the ratio of ferrous to ferric ion. Same way, there may be numerical problem based on the calculation of number of us to each ion in cuprous oxide or in nickel oxide. 3 or 4 numerical problems in given in the exercise of the NCERT, please solve it. Now, after discussing the metal deficiency defect, let us discuss the impurity defect. What will happen if some impurity will replace the metal cation? Let us examine it. If molten NaCl containing a little amount of SrCl2 is crystallized, some of the site of the Na plus ions are occupied by Sr ion, strontium ion, as clear from this figure. Each Sr2 plus ion replaces 2 sodium ion because the charge on Sr2 plus ion is 2 unit positive, while the charge on sodium ion is unit positive. So, 1 Sr ion is equivalent to 2 sodium ion. So, what will happen? This Sr ion will occupy the site of 1 sodium ion while the other site of sodium ion will remain empty. So, the cationic vacancy thus produced. And what will happen? Number of positive charge, number of negative charge is same. This causes, presence of impurities causes cationic deficiency. And due to presence of, or you may say it, positive hole, because positive ion is missing, positive hole. So, it will act as a p-type semiconductance. As there is a presence of hole, the density will decrease also. So it will show some electrical conductance. It will show decrease in the density. Similar is the case where cadmium chloride, some small amount of cadmium chloride is mixed with silver chloride and crystallizes out. What will happen? Some cadmium ion will occupy the site of the silver ion. So what will happen? What will be the consequence of that? Each cadmium ion is equivalent to 2 silver ion. So at the site of one cadmium ion will be occupying its position while the other site of silver ion will remain vacant. So again there will be metal deficiency defect because number of cations in the crystal has reduced. So it is metal deficiency defect. It is metal excess defect. Here what we see? Metal deficiency defect. This is in 2T defect, in which the number of cation has reduced. Vacancy created by SR ion here, because one strontium ion is equivalent to two sodium ion. Likewise, if it is in case of AgCl, when CdCl2, Cd ion will be occupying this position, one charge on one Cd ion will be equivalent to charge on two silver ion. So at the site of one silver ion, this cadmium ion will be bivalent, cadmium ion will be occupying its position, and while the other site of silver ion will remain empty. So it will cause the metal deficiency defect, impurity defect. It arises because of the presence of some impurity inside the crystal. So basically, what we understand after discussing of this topic, that impurity is caused due to the number one, presence of vacancy in the crystal, number two, by the dislocation of the particle, and sometimes by the presence of impurity. So we will have to know the defect properly. First of all, we will discuss about the stoichiometric point defect, in which mainly we will focus on Schottky defect and Frenkel defect. And number two, in non-stoichiometric point defect, first in detail we will study about the metal excess defect caused due to the anionic vacancy. Number two, we will discuss properly the metal excess defect due to presence of extra cation. Third, metal deficiency defect here, as in case of transition metal oxide. And at last, we will discuss about the impurity defect. In my next video, I will discuss about the electrical property and magnetic property of the solid. Till then, it's bye.